scattered like shells and lost to the sea. Like the river, the days move rapidly. I have all these memories I don't know what for. I have a man I can't help. Some overflow and spill out like waves. Some I will harbor for all of my days. I burn like oil, you bloom like a flower. Grow.
For my sons, Thomas, who's already at peace, and Jackson, may he never know this life of chaos.
You are not mine. Our true love finds us when it is time.
Most of us were not violent by nature. We all had our problems with authority, but none of us were sociopaths. We came to realize that when you move your life off the social grid, you give up the safety that society provides. On the fringe, blood and bullets are the rule of law. And if you're a man with convictions, violence is inevitable. When we take action to avenge the ones we love, personal justice collides with social and divine justice. We become judge, jury, and God. With that choice comes daunting responsibility. Some men cave under that weight. Others abuse the momentum. The true outlaw finds the balance between the passion in his heart and the reason in his mind. His solution is always an equal mix of might and right. First time I read Emma Goldman wasn't in a book. I was 16, hiking near the Nevada border. The quote was painted on a wall in red. When I saw those words, it was like someone ripped them from the inside of my head.
Anarchism stands for liberation of the human mind from the dominion of religion, liberation of the human body from the dominion of property. Liberation from shackles and the restraint of government. It stands for social order, based on the free grouping of individuals.
The concept was pure, simple, true. It inspired me, lit a rebellious fire. But ultimately, I learned the lesson that Goldman, Proudhon, and the others learned, that true freedom requires sacrifice and pain. Most human beings only think they want freedom. In truth, they yearn for the bondage of social order, rigid laws, materialism. The only freedom man really wants is the freedom to be comfortable. The older I get, the more I realize that age doesn't bring wisdom. It only brings weary. I'm not any smarter than I was 30 years ago. I've just grown too tired to juggle the lies and hide the fears. Self-awareness doesn't reveal my indiscretions. Exhaustion does. Inside the club, there had to be truth. Our word was our honor. But outside, it was all about deception. Lies were our defense, our default. To survive, you had to master the art of perjury. The lie and the truth had to feel the same. But once you learn that skill, nobody knows the truth, in or outside the club, especially you. Einstein said that any intelligent fool can make things bigger, more complex, and more violent. but it takes a touch of genius and lots of courage to move something in the opposite direction. I'm realizing that my touch of genius and my courage are coming too little, too late. And I fear that for Sam CRO, there may be no opposite direction. I never made a conscious decision to have the club become one thing or another. It just happened before my eyes. Each savage event was a catalyst for the next. And by the time the violence reached epic proportion, I couldn't see it. Blood was every color.
Boxes. It's what he found in storage when Abel was born. He wrote it all down. All his pathetic hopes and dreams. This is a book of failures and fixes. John is speaking to him from the goddamn grave.
You'll be in hysterics.
I told you to nail Jax down. Bring him closer.
This is a bunch of words. This is a bunch of shit.
It means everything to my Jax. I know my son. He is restless. Just like his old man. Always looking for something more. The reasons why. This shit is gonna send him on a destiny run. Reading those secrets. Finding out about the Donna mistake. What happened to John? I cannot do that again. Not with him.
Now you listen to me. What he read there were the ramblings of a bitter, grieving coward. I mean, look at it. It's halfway burned. Probably pissed him off. So don't tell me he's poisoned. And this shit with Donna, there's nothing to know. So you better calm down. This is about your fear, your history. You stop bleeding all over him. And finish burning that.
To my oldest, dearest, and wisest friend, what we started, you and I, was a good thing, for a good reason. What we've become is a different thing, for reasons I no longer understand. I feel angry winds at my back, and I'm not sure how much time I have left in this cut I love so much. This book is for all the things we wanted, and for all the things we still can be. I love you, brother. JT.
He refused to answer, 'cause he wanted a good action.
Time for a change.
Tell me who's that riding down the Revelator? Tell me who's that riding down the Revelator? Who's that riding down the Revelator? Wrote the book of the seven seas. Now tell me who's that riding down the Revelator? Tell me who's that riding down the Revelator? Who's that writer down the Revelator? Wrote the book of the seven seals.
Yeah.
I realized that in my downward spiral of hopelessness, I was actually falling into the huge hole created by my absence of basic human graces. The most obvious was forgiveness. If I was wronged by anyone, in or out of the club, I had to be compensated. money or blood. There was no turning the other cheek. When relationships become a ledger of profit and loss, you have no friends, no loved ones, just pluses and minuses. You are absolutely alone.
I loved your dad more than I've loved any man. Great leg, smart, big heart, and very complicated. Sound familiar? His complications killed him.
What do you mean?
I don't think your father's death was an accident. I think he hated his life and he let the road take it. I don't want that same fate for you, Jackson.
I found myself lost in my own club. I trusted few, feared most. Nomad offered escape and exile. I didn't know if leaving would cure or kill this thing we created. I didn't know if it was an act of strength or cowardice. I didn't know, so I stayed. I stayed because in the end, the only way I could hold this up was to suffer under the weight of it.
I do, man.
Like, you're loyal, decent. You love the right things. That's who he was. And I miss him. I miss him.
Understand. You said my dad was a soldier. I know. He was a member of the club. Find a member. John. John, tell her. Why wouldn't you tell me that? Why the hell did you lie to me?
I lied to everybody, Trini. Your nana shipped me off to Dublin to have you in secret. She wanted me to give you up for Catholic adoption. I couldn't do that. John had another life, another family. And when he died so young, I thought it best to give you a better memory. Neil Duffy was a lad I knew that was killed in the line of duty. He was a sweet, noble lad. He'd no kin, no loose ends to untie. I almost shagged my brother, Ma. You know how humiliating that is. Sorry, Trini. Yes, knows about this.
Apparently John didn't tell anyone.
Clay?
No. Sorry I had to find out like this.
Yeah, no shit. 2 minutes later, I'd have been dancing in Tig territory.
I'm about to break a vow. An oath of confidentiality I had with your father.
What does that have to do with my kid?
Everything. Sit. Sit. Well, I got to know JT very well. I loved him like a brother.
Well, that makes sense, doesn't it? Considering he had a kid with your sister.
I listened to his confession for over 3 years. I heard every sin and sorrow he carried. Your father's pain distilled into one resolute desire. That his sons never followed his path. He never wanted this life for you.
Why are you telling me this?
Because he died before he could keep his promise. I couldn't do anything to help save the son. But I can do something to save the grandson.
Save him from what?
The life of his father.
Dear Mo, I don't know what I'd do without you. These letters are the only thing keeping me sane. I'm so lost here in Charming. Nothing feels familiar. The club, my family, everyone's a stranger. My grief and introspection terrifies them. It drives Gemma mad. And Clay's pity has moved into profound loathing. I see my best friend and my wife growing closer and closer. I have no jealousy, truly. I feel nothing. Not even fear. And I know I should be afraid.
Not my father. I love you more than you
could ever know. I'd do anything to be with you. Every day, it becomes more clear that I don't belong here. I'm certain now that Clay and Jim are together. They barely try to hide it from me. Gemma hates my apathy. She hates all of me. Her chill is terrifying. I know my days are numbered, Mo. And when these letters stop, you can be certain that my death will come at the hands of my wife and best friend. At least my sweet Thomas will never suffer my life. I miss him so much. I only pray that Jackson finds a different path. He already reminds me so much of myself. Gemma's always been stronger than me. I loved her for that. But as I lost my way, she found hers. She's moved closer to Clay, grown deeply committed to the club. She's become more the woman I married, and I've become less the man. The death of our love is my failing, not hers.
Tell me about John Teller. What was he like?
He's a complicated guy. He was angry and impulsive. Just righteous as hell. Hated being wrong. Not much of an education. Book smart, though. I used to devour 3 and 4 of them at a time. He was loyal. Too loyal.
That sounds familiar.
Yeah, they're cut from the same cloth. You know what I want to know? Why my best friend was afraid when he died.
I found some of JT's old letters. He was trying to get the club out of the gun business. He knew it was a risk. Clay and the others were invested.
Trying to get him out, how?
From what I read, he had set up a meeting in Belfast with some IRA members and a priest.
Kellen Ashby?
Yes. John wanted to end the relationship with the Irish, stop the club from selling guns. He was killed before that meeting happened.
JT would have never touched drugs.
JT was a good businessman. He'd seen the value in this.
John knew that anything that brought too much heat was bad for the club. That's why he changed his mind about the guns. Remember?
Yeah, he talked about that. Getting us out.
Now, he did more than talk. He reached out to Kellen, set a meet with the IRA, made a decision to get us out of the gun running business. A decision that you couldn't let him live with.
Your near-death experience gets you talking to ghosts, old man?
No, not exactly. We found some old letters. John's handwriting, proof that he wanted out. Proof that he feared you would do something to stop him. Before that meet could ever happen, John Teller was murdered. And the letters, they paint a vivid picture of who did it.
JT laid his bike down on 580. He was crushed by a semi. It was an accident.
We'll never know. Lowell Sr. disappeared the next week, and he was the only one JT trusted to work on his bike. For 10 years, I gave up on this club. Rode my limit just to keep the patch. And then you came up. You know, you reminded me so much of John. Just... it felt like maybe our idea still had a chance.
Well, I'm not my old man.
Oh, I'm very clear on that now.
You need to rip him off the pedestal, Piney. JT bailed on all of us. You try to tell me you didn't know about Maureen Ashby? About Trinity?
Maureen was a distraction. But when your brother took a turn for the worse, your dad was right back here.
Yeah, damage already done.
We all do damage. Character is determined by how we repair it.
Well, JT didn't repair much.
He didn't have a chance. You do.
I'm fixing what matters. You know, my old man was right about one thing. This club has lost its way. And I thought I was the guy that was gonna change that. And then I realized that that arrogance, that belief that one man can change it, is what drove my old man into the ground.
Defeat is not what killed your father.
I don't wanna hear about history. I'm taking care of what's in front of me.
You and Clay both.
This isn't about Clay. It's about me. It's about me figuring out what I gotta do today that keeps me alive tomorrow. This ain't about the club, Piney. It's about my family.
I won't tell you how much you just sounded like your old man. Your father was... he was the best man I ever knew. And before you let him die, you should find him. And know that for yourself.
There's a few other things I can't prove. My father wrote letters to Maureen Ashby, telling her that he feared Clay would kill him for trying to get the club out of guns. He even told her he'd sabotage his bike. Clay killed my old man. Maureen put the letters in my bag when we left Belfast. Tara found them, gave them to Piney. Clay found out. That's why he killed Piney. That's why he tried to kill Tara. Clay was the one that ordered the attack on her. He's responsible for what happened to our hand. He's responsible for everything.
Send our love to the sky.
Some of you knew my old man. Some just knew his legacy.
It's no secret that he was conflicted at the end. Questioned every decision he'd ever made. About the club. About his family. That fear. That doubt. It ruined him. Made him vulnerable. I'm here to tell you that I'm not following that path. The choices that I make are not because I'm afraid or because I have any doubts about this club.
John was trying to get the club out of guns. It was as tense then as it is now. He was making trips back and forth to Belfast, trying to make it right with the Irish. He fell in love with someone. Maureen Ashby. Brother was a priest, friend of John's. Helping broker a peaceful transition with the IRA. I found out. Started spending time with Clay. My Thomas died when John was away on one of those trips. And I wasn't kind when he got home. Pain and anger at losing my baby. I made sure it landed on him. He came undone after that. Talks with the IRA fell apart. Clay and McGee put him back together again. In the other direction. Solidified the gun trade for the club. Made them players. But JT. He started writing in this journal, a manuscript. It's a bleeding confession, questioning all his choices, regretting everything he'd ever done in Sam CRO. He stopped caring about the club, about his family. And it was a dangerous time here. Mayan war. Feds infiltrating MCs. Everyone was scared. JT was a weak link.
You had the chance to be something good for this club. Something your old man always wanted. You turned into everything he hated. You became the poison. The reason he checked out.
Checked out of what?
I was the only one JT trusted at the end.
You weren't even a member of the club back then.
That's why. I knew the life, but I didn't wear his patch. I was just a friend, a safe ear.
So what did he tell you?
John couldn't live with what the club had become. But he also couldn't bring himself to take it down.
Take it down how?
He wrote some kind of book. I never read it. But whatever was in it, if it would have gotten out, would have destroyed the sons and tore apart his family. What do you think happened to your old man that day? Out on 580.
Clay sabotaged his bike.
Yeah, we heard those rumors. But there was one thing that didn't hook up for me. That panhead was an extension of John. He would have known if anything was wrong with it the second he kicked it over.
Meaning what? You think my old man ran into that semi on purpose?
I don't know. Maybe it was his sacrifice. a way of letting his club and family survive.
My old man didn't kill himself.
It doesn't matter. As long as he ain't here to see what Sam Crow did to you.
Come on. Come here. Hey, baby. I just wanted to come by to give you something.
Okay.
Honey, this was your Grandpa John's. And I gave it to your daddy when he patched into the club. This one's for you. So you have it when you become a member.
I think the struggle I understand best. Even more than all the things you wanted for Sam Crow. What we eventually became. The one I feel the most is the war of the mind. Happens when you try to get right with both family and Patch. That fear and guilt crippled me. I realized, as I think you did, a good father and a good outlaw can't settle inside the same man. Too late for me. I was already inside her. Gemma. She had plans. It's not too late for my boys. I promise they will never know this life of chaos.
Copy. Please stand by.
I know who you are now. What you did. I love you, Dad.